Welcome to Brain Academy. Okay, so in this video, we are going to talk about optrust. So to understand optrust, let's look at a simple example. Let's say there is a well. Okay, a deep well. And in the well, there is water up to this level, let's say. There is water. And let's say there is a small bucket here. Okay, you put a bucket. Let's say you put a bucket here. And there's a roll. And you're trying to pull this water out. Now, what will happen or what you'll notice is that when you are pulling this bucket full of water up to this point, it will feel really light. But when this bucket reaches here, at this point, this bucket starts to feel heavy. And it continues to feel heavy. So this bucket is feeling light inside water, but it feels heavy outside water. Now, why does that happen? And there's a simple reason for that. What happens is the water applies a little bit upward force on this bucket, and this upward force makes it easy to pull out this bucket or makes it light. Now this upward force that is being applied by water on this bucket, this upward force is optrust. That's it. So if you need to define optrust, you define it like when something is immersed in liquid, when an object is fully or partially immersed in a liquid, there's this upward force, right? It feels an upward force. And that force is called optrust. And that's it. Now the optrust is done, let's look at density. So density is very simple. It's about how compact something is. So density is compactness. So let's say there's this substance, there's this object, and there's another one object. So if the molecules in this object are very, very compact, then it means this body has high density. And if the molecules in a body are very, very loose, like in case of air, it means it has low density. So density is just about compactness, how tight something is or how compact things are. But in science, if you look at it in a little bit numerical way, so it's about how much mass there is in a fixed volume, so in unit volume. And so we can define it as mass per unit volume. Unit volume is called density. So if there's, let's say, 1 liter bottle and it's very, very heavy, it means it has high density. In the same 1 liter volume, if there is like it's very, very light, then it has low density. So it's about how much mass there is in a certain compact substance or in a fixed volume. That's density for you. Okay, now let's talk about relative density. So relative density means it's relative to something, like we compare it with something, and that something is actually water. So whenever we compare a density of any substance, with the density of water, then that's relative density. Now, we all know that the density of water is 1000 kilogram per cubic meters. So the density of water is 1000. Now what relative density talks about or says is how dense something is than water. So it's comparing the density of a substance with the density of water. Now let's look at relative density of mercury for now. So relative density of mercury. So the relative density of mercury is 13.6. So what does that mean? It means that mercury is 13.6 times more dense than water. Or in simple terms, if you look at a bottle of water. So let's say this is 1 liter bottle and you put water here. You fill this with water. Now this 1 liter bottle water will weigh 1 kg or 1 kilogram. And in the same bottle, if you keep mercury, same bottle, it doesn't look same, but imagine it's the same bottle. And if you fill this with mercury, now the mass of this bottle will be 13.6 kilograms. So it will be 13.6 times more heavier than this water. So that's all relative density is about. It's about how heavy or how dense something is than water. So here I forgot to mention that the density of water is actually 1000 at 4 degrees Celsius. It's max at 4 degrees Celsius. So sometimes it's written as density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. So it's the same thing. So please don't be confused in this. And that's our relative density. Now, if you want to define relative density, you can define it as, so this is the formula for relative density. Relative density. So you can define it as the density. So you can just define everything from the formula. The density of a substance per unit. So this line is per unit. Density of water at 4 degrees Celsius is called relative density. Now, why are we talking about density and obtuseness in the same video? Because they're kind of related. So they're actually directly proportional to each other, which means if a substance is more dense or if a liquid is more dense, it'll give more obtuseness. And if it's less dense, it'll give less obtuseness. So let's say we have water. And water is dense, but not so much dense. Okay. So this is water. And let's make mercury here. So let's say this is mercury. Now mercury is more denser than water. So this is mercury. Both of them are liquid, but what we know is the density of mercury is high and the density of water is low compared to mercury. Now since the density of water is low, there are less molecules, so the obtuseness will be less. There's less molecules, so the obtuseness will also be less. Whereas here, there are lots of molecules because it's very dense and the obtuseness will also be more. So they are kind of directly proportional. So when there is high density, the obtuseness will also be high because there are lots of molecules. And when there is less density, then the obtuseness will also be low. And that's how they are related to each other. Now, this relation is important in our other laws, like in Archimedes' principle and law of flotation. That's why we need to understand this topic clearly before we move on to those topics. Thank you.